Hi everyone, I am a data science and business analytics internship candidate in Spark Foundation, and today I would like to deliver a lecture on prediction using Superva machine learning. So this is Nikon, and these are the link I provided, social link as you can follow by that. So we come to the our main goal. What are our object? Our object is here mentioned that we want to predict the number of percentage under the number of study hours in one day. For example, if a student studied one day 10 hours, what will be the end result in after the last 1 year? So for that we use a simple linear regression algorithm. So here I import some libraries, import pandas, numpy, matplotlib and seaborn. These are libraries we support to execute numerical visualization, plotting and other. You can also study more about these libraries, just google it. So there are different steps to solve linear regression problem. First we've import different libraries. Why we use linear regression? Just come to here. This is first task of internship. This is first project. Here they mention what we will do, and the data sets is also here. I also provided the link in below description. So you can use R language, Python and SAS RW tool to visualization. Here they also mention the linear regression in this task, and linear regression involved two variable is extracted by using a feature extraction techniques. So come to the our main goal. So here just I would like to import the different type of libraries. Here I want to load or read the data from local machine. Local machine is your laptop, computer, data cell. So path is here, copy it from here. Just control B, you can import your data from this side, and here data. So I have a, here is another data. I have task here, task number one. Here is data set. I can import here and you can import from your local machine. Anyhow, I hope you know about how can import data from local machine to a Jupyter notebook. So I have just copied the path from there, and all path is mentioned. This is our data set. So just I load onto the machine. It is loaded. I want to read the path. Read, successfully read it. And now I would like to check the shape of data. What is the shape of data? Shape of data means how many columns and rows on concerned data. So I would like to check the head of data, either the data is labeled or not. If data is not labeled, then we will do that. But here the data is labeled hours and score. If the student studied 2.5 hours one day, what will be the result? 21% percentage and 5%, 47 and so on. So just we execute this one to find the information about data set. So data contain either the null values or not. Here is no null value, and hours and score, two type of data, and that is float and integer. So just to describe the all statistical values which is calculated in statics. So here all values is auto calculated by our machine. So here count, means, standard deviation, minimum and other percentages according to the given values respectively. So here we just plot the data in x, y and z, just like two coordinate, two things as a correlation. So first here the first code recognize, the first code represent the code, this code represent for plotting x axis in hour and y axis in percentage score, and this one title is mentioned here, and these are the x and y mentioned. So just plot this one, what will be the result? The result is this one. and here is a good correlation is increasingly from 0 to the highest, just like a 45 degrees angle. So we have different type of methods to check the correlation, it is good or not. We have a Pearson method, we check this one, FR is this and the percentage is this and scores and so on. So just the next method is Spearman. This is also the same result from the Pearson method. So just we distribute two things, hours and scores. Here we distribute the hours. Where is the result? It is very good result because here is no outlier. If outlier is found here, then it will be not so good for output. So it is good. Next, we just distribute the scores. Here's distribution is also just like this one. It is also good because it also does not contain outlier. So from the above, what we will observe, from the above graph, we clearly see that there is a clearly positive linear correlation between the student concerned data, their student number of percentage increases time schedule increase. So number third step in data visualization is what? Preparing data by using linear R. Here just we prepare the data just into levels. So just run this one. Data is prepared. When data is prepared, then we try to import the model by using Scala and model. We split the data and that is our training process. The data is trained. When data is trained, the next step is the algorithm training. When algorithm is trained, you can hear the training algorithm is successfully. Now we just apply the linear regression equation. This is a linear regression equation, L is equal to mx plus c, just like this one. We just plot a good fit. If we run this one, what will we do? This is a good fit in between. When the data point x axis in y-axis, x-axis in y-axis, and so on, it increases gradually. So it is a good fit. So just we make predictions some here 1.5 and 7 and so on. We check the data set y prediction and this one actual R prediction. What will we do here? When actual is 20, we predict 16. Actual 27, we predict 33. Something is not a good between the actual and predicted values, not a great or big difference. It is well a little difference between them. So here we just check the plot, the data set. Here a very enormously increasing the data. Here we predict the what will be the predicted score if student score is for 925. This is given in our assignment work here. You can check to 25 per day. So we put the 9 here, H this one. So we put here and output is what? We check this one. Either you run this code to your local machine, it shows the if a student study for 9.25 hours per day, he or she will score 91% in exam. Now the last one step is what? That is model evaluation. Just to run this code, what will here? Mean absolute error and R2 error, R-square error calculated. So this is our task. We want to put the data into the local machine by using JupyterLab and by using different type of libraries. We will find the result. So thank